Today we're going to be building Cubico's chemistry kaleidoscope. I hope you guys are ready to see some groovy science. The first step, we must prepare our laboratory. So, go ahead and grab your three beakers and your mess mat. This thing has saved my desk so many times. So go ahead and flatten out your mess mat, put your three beakers up here. Next up, we're gonna focus on our clear beaker. Set these two aside. And you're gonna grab some water from home and fill it up to the 25 milliliter mark. Next, you can grab your watercolors and we're gonna add some color to this beaker. If you wanna see different colors you can mix up, go ahead and check this chart here. I think I'm gonna do this color. So I'm gonna do two drops of blue and one drop of yellow.
One big drop of this. One, two.
All right, we'll set these aside. Then you're gonna wanna grab your stir stick. So this end is a scoop, we'll wanna keep that end dry, and this end is for stirring. So we'll stick this end in here and give it a little stir. Yes, that's such a pretty color. Okay, perfect. I'll set that on my mess mat. All right, so this is done. We'll set it over here. Next up, the medium color one. We're gonna go ahead and take our oil and take the cap off. And then also take off this foil piece. I'm actually gonna set this down and use my stir stick to punch it. And for this, we're also gonna fill up to that 25 millimeter mark. Set it on the level ground. Perfect. And then last up is our dark blue container. So we're gonna fill up about 35 milliliters. There's 20, perfect. Right in between those two lines. And then for this one, we're actually gonna put a cap full of glycerin in there. Take the lid off this one. And again, you're gonna wanna pop that foil. So one capful. That's about one capful. Perfect. And give it a little stir. Now that we've got our three beakers color-coded with all the right stuff in there, we're gonna go ahead and put in our three color-coded eyedroppers. So dark blue and dark blue and blue, and then white and white. Next up, we're just gonna practice using these eyedroppers real quick. If you've never used one before, this is how you do it. So remember, squeeze and then put in, unsqueeze. And then a bunch of liquid will pull up in here. You can practice squeezing it out and doing it again. All right, time for experiment number one. Set these over here. So for this, we're actually gonna be filling up one of our test tubes that we'll use in our kaleidoscope. So go ahead and grab a test tube and a foam donut. And then we're also gonna make sure to take off the cap, very important. Set it over here. And to make this easier to fill up, definitely use your funnel. Otherwise, it's really tricky. So we're gonna set that in there, and now it'll catch all the liquid. So now that we've practiced our eyedropper skills, we're gonna go ahead and fill this test tube up halfway with this green liquid. So squeeze, unsqueeze, and then perfect. Now that that's halfway full, I'm gonna fill up the rest of the way with oil. And that's the light blue one, if you remember. Ooh. Oil is so much thicker, so that's why it fills a little bit slower than the water. All right, let's put this in. The science word for extra goopy is viscous. Very fun. All right, so now that this is filled all the way with oil, we can set our funnel off to the side, screw our cap back on very tightly, very important step, and then give it a shake. Cool. It's like a little lava lamp in a test tube. All right, now that we've finished that file, we can go ahead and set it to the side. And next up, we're gonna make our party test tube. So go ahead and grab a foam donut and take the lid off of one of your test tubes, place it here. You're gonna wanna grab your rainbow dots and your shiny sequins. So go ahead and take the lids off, set them over here, and then go ahead and use your scoop. It should be dry. Go ahead and get two scoops of your rainbow dots. Scoop one and two. Excellent. This is why we have a mess mat, folks. And we'll do three scoops of our shiny sequins. Two, three, perfect. All right, now we can set these over here. We're gonna use the funnel again. Place this in here. And do three scoops of these super tiny beads. Hold it very carefully. One, two, three. I'm gonna put the lid back on this one because I feel like I'm for sure gonna spill it. And then what you can do if you wanna get a little bit of extra stuff that's left on your funnel out, you go tap, 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 tap. Perfect. All right, now that we've got all of our beads in, go ahead and leave the funnel in and we're gonna fill it all the way to the top with the glycerin mixture. That's this dark blue beaker. All right, so squeeze, unsqueeze, tap. And we're gonna try to fill all the way to the top. Perfect. Set your beaker to the side, set your funnel to the side, and go ahead and again, close it very tightly. You really don't want this to spray everywhere. All right. Now that you've squeezed it tight, you've got a density tube. So you can go ahead and shake this one and see how all of the things want to be on different layers. It's really similar to the oil and the water, but instead of the oil and water separating, all of these beads want to be at different heights too. Isn't that cool? Let's see who wants to float to the top. Okay, my rainbow dots totally want to be at the top. So the sequins feel like they could be anywhere in the mixture, but the beads totally want to be at the bottom. Awesome, so you made another density tower. So for our last vial, we actually get to make our own custom confetti. So go ahead and grab an adult to help you out with this section. Have them either preheat your oven or toaster oven to 325 degrees. Next, grab a baking sheet and some tin foil. All right, now it's time to make some custom confetti. So you can either punch these out or draw your own if you'd like to. I'm gonna punch these out. Do this one. This one, I want all science themed. That one, ooh, wow, there's a dinosaur head. This is an illustration of a product I made. Make sure you're putting these down so that the nice art is facing up and not upside down. So when we put these in the toaster oven and we're only gonna put them in for a minute, these will all shrink up. So it's all printed on this type of plastic that will want to shrink when it gets hot. So they'll start out this size and then they'll end up really teeny, teeny, tiny. All right, now they're ready for the oven. Go ahead and get an adult to place them in the oven for you. And then don't go anywhere. This will only take 1 to 2 minutes. Watch the discs the entire time they're in the oven. They should be curling and shrinking in the first 60 to 120 seconds. Then when they stop moving, wait about 30 seconds and then take them on out. You can bake as many batches as you'd like, but just remember to turn off the oven when you're done. If you notice that some of your confetti is curling up, you can use the bottom of the glass to try to flatten it while it's still warm. They're so tiny! I can't believe they got so small. All right, now that our shrinking inks have nice and cooled, thank you, grown-up assistant, we're ready to add them to our vial. So go ahead and take the lid off and then add as many of these discs as you'd like. I'm gonna add all of them, because I like them all. Okay, so now that all of our discs are in there, we can add the funnel back. and then we're gonna fill it all the way to the top with the rest of our glycerin mixture.
Up.
Perfect. And then make sure to put on the lid very, very, very tightly. Wow. All right, now it's done. Go ahead and give it a shake and check it out. So because this one also has the glycerin mixture in it, you'll see that your little discs here want to kind of float and glide very gently. Again, that's because the glycerin is really, really thick. So it has to move slower through here than it would in normal water. Wow. So what's going on with these? How do they get so tiny? So these shrink discs are made from a special kind of plastic. When it's in the factory, the sheet of plastic is stretched super thin and then cooled really, really quickly so it stays like that. Then when you put it in the oven, it can reheat up back to its original shape and pull itself all together again. So it's not getting any smaller, it's still all the same material, it's just getting more dense. Isn't that cool? All right, now that we've finished up in our laboratory, it's time to clear all this off and get building to make our kaleidoscope. All right, step number one. First, we're gonna wanna peel off these backers. We've gotta make sure our mirrors are nice and reflective. Next, let's take our thinnest mirror and this blue piece over here and slot them together. Make sure that the peg is pointing down. Next, go ahead and grab this mirror and slot it into the space on this side. And we're gonna do the same with the other mirror. With kaleidoscopes, it's super critical that all of the mirrors are on the inside and facing each other. So just go ahead and double check that none of your mirrors are facing out. Awesome. To secure these into place, let's use two green bolts. Perfect. Next, we're gonna take this yellow piece and line up these two little teeth with the two square holes in the middle of your kaleidoscope. Click, nice. Next, we're gonna grab the blue version of that piece and put it over here next to this other blue plastic piece. Perfect. Lastly, let's put on the eyepiece to hold it all together. So go ahead and notch here first and then push up this panel and slide it all on. Make sure that it's all the way on. Awesome, let's try it out real quick. Look through this hole right here and you should be able to see tons of awesome reflections. Whoa! How many reflections can you see? All right, next grab all three of these blue pieces. The biggest one, we're actually gonna flip over like this and then place this rubber one inside of it. Wish. Awesome. And then to cap it all off, we'll grab the last piece. It should have a little Steve the Kiwi logo on it, and go ahead and place that right on top. Perfect. Just make sure it's all nice and squished down. Awesome. So if we have our kaleidoscope like this with the peg pointing up, then let's put it on with that logo still facing up as well. And double check that that's lined up right there. And then to hold it all in place, let's add a yellow plastic gear. Twist it nice and tight. Next, go ahead and double check that this kind of clicks into three positions and can't swing all the way around. If it's rotating all the way around like that, then take off your yellow gear and you'll just need to flip this over. Ta-da! Great. Now that we've finished building the kaleidoscope, let's go ahead and add the test tubes. So take it out of the base, and then you're gonna push it up through the bottom. Awesome. So this way, when you're looking through, you can see
all your different experiments.
Whoa, my shrinky dinks are huge again. If your test tube holder isn't clicking into place like this, then go ahead and flip it over and double check that the logo is facing up and that this yellow gear is twisted all the way down. And if you're having a hard time seeing good reflections in the mirrors or they're just really dull, then go ahead and double check that you did step one and that you removed all of the filters off of the mirrors. All right, here's some tips to see your chemistry in action. Because these are all density towers, you gotta flip it every now and again to see that density resettle. That way you'll have some really cool stuff to see in here. And if you are looking through here and things kind of look really slow or like nothing's moving much, you can always shake it while you're looking or rotate it around or dip it on its side or even switch between them while you're looking through it. There's no rules. And if you want to keep mixing it up, you can try combinations like this. We've got Thick and Thin, Confetti Chaos, and Triple Play. Or you can even try to make your own custom color by using this chart here. So how exactly do kaleidoscopes work? Let's reflect on the science for a little bit. So light, as it travels, bounces off of stuff. And most things, like my face, will bounce off a little bit of light. But things like mirrors can bounce a ton of light. So what a kaleidoscope does is it gets a bunch of mirrors all together so that when a little bit of light comes in, it bounces off one, then the other, then the other, then the other, and it bounces around and around and around. And that's how you get the same really beautiful image repeated over and over and over again to make these really cool patterns. And that's the science of kaleidoscopes. Thanks so much for building along with us today. And if you want to see more cool builds like this, then go ahead and subscribe to our channel. Until next time. Here, how about one of these? Completely out of focus.